Broadcasting from the Horton Grand Theater in America's finest city, this is Tonight in San Diego. This week's guest, magician David Bonfadini. Pro skateboarder, Mitchie Brusco. Tonight's musical guest, DJ Noel 2033. Featuring DJ Thielen, I'm Jesse Egan, and here's your host, Jeff.
San Diego! Welcome to Tonight in San Diego. I'm your host, Jeff Kraft. What a great crowd we have
good
here.
Crowd
good looking
tonight,
crowd. Good looking crowd. You know, tonight, unlike Knock Knock Live, this is our 50th episode of Tonight in San Diego. Yeah. That's right. Knock Knock Live made it two episodes. Two episodes. You guys hear about that? Knock Knock Live, Ryan Seacrest? No? Nobody watched it. Nobody watched. That's why it only went two episodes.
That's right.
You know, a lot of shows they make maybe the last 50 years. I don't know, maybe the last 50 days. Tell you what we're going to do to celebrate our 50 episodes here on Tonight in San Diego. We're going to show you in depth the last 50 minutes of Tonight in San Diego. Take a look. Is exactly what happens every Monday night, 50 minutes before the show. We don't make this stuff up. It happens.
Every week.
It happens. Hey, let's go to headlines.
Headlines, what you want. That's what you get. Oh, oh. Headlines, what you want.
That, my friends, DJ Thielen, right there. Every week, something different.
That was good. There was a lot of stank on that this week, Thielen. I like that.
I'm not even cool enough to use that word.
Stank.
All right, well, let's go to headlines. Let's start in Hong Kong. A woman in Hong Kong has been charged for assaulting a police officer with her breasts. Yeah, apparently the police officer warned her to stop, saying, "I'm going to count to 100. Slowly. And by the time I get there, you better have stopped."
Yeah. Sounds like he was really milking that breast situation there, Jeff.
It definitely sounds like that. From Hong Kong to San Diego. In San Diego, a man was caught posing as a modeling agent in an attempt to lure women. And now the women, well, they became suspicious when they saw his previous experience included stand-up comedian and jealous spokesperson.
Oh. Too soon for a pudding pop reference, Jeff.
J-E-L-L-O. Mm. Walmart, they've given $285,000 to local nonprofits around San Diego.
Wow.
That's pretty good.
That's a lot of money.
That's pretty good. Yeah. Now, to give you a perspective on how much money that is for Walmart, it's the combined salary of 285,000 store greeters. Mm. Yeah. Oh. I know. Hillary Clinton, well, she finished working on her early campaign ad titled Dorothy. Meanwhile, in Washington, D.C., Bill Clinton also finished working on a girl named Dorothy.
Hey, now.
You know, Bill Clinton, I did not have sexual relations. Subway spokesman Jared Fogle appears to have paid a girl $100 to have sex.
Wow.
$100 to have sex, poor Jared. So instead of a $5 foot long, you can get a $100 two-incher. I'll make it a little bigger for you, Jared. The CEO of Taco Bell said he wants to deliver an experience that really matters to the current generation. Yeah, that way, the entire family can bond over sitting on the toilet together.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Family that poos together stays together, Jeff.
Is that how it goes?
That's gross. I don't know. It's not.
Dr. Seuss released a book titled, What Pet Should I Get?
Nice.
Yeah. The book got a lot of attention and even inspired a ripoff. It's called, What Ethnicity Should I Use for Publicity? By Donald Trump. Oh. That's headlines. We have got a tremendous show here tonight. We've got magician David Bonfadini. He's here. Funny guy. Yeah. Funny guy. David Bonfadini, he's going to be here. We've also got pro skateboarder, also the only person to do a 1080 off the mega ramp. You know what that is?
Is this the mega ramp?
That right is not the mega ramp. It is unbelievable. Mitchie Brusco will be here as well here tonight. And a fantastic musical guest here tonight on the resident management stage, DJ Noel 2033 will be here as well. I told you it's a big show. But real quick, here is Stiegler Photography's Photo Bomb of the Week. We'll be back. Well, ladies and gentlemen, here he is, street magician, magician himself, David Bonfadini.
From San Diego!
Yeah! Woo! Woo! It's a good crowd.
I'm loving it. Hi, everyone. You want to see some magic?
I do.
Well, good. I have one for you.
Okay, what do you got?
Let's see here. So here I have two skate wheels.
Okay.
Go ahead and check them out. They're
all
right. Real. Okay, and this is rope. Go ahead and check that out. Very good. It's not licorice.
You didn't take the wheels off the kid's skateboard for later, did you?
Yeah, I missed you. Yeah. Okay.
Oh.
That's our guest. He's going to...
My bad.
I know he's going to pull that 1080 now.
Oh, well. Okay, so here we go. Ready?
Okay.
Go ahead and pull. Okay, very good. Pull.
Okay.
It's a little awkward. Okay, good. Let go. Very good.
All right.
Ladies and gentlemen, yeah, let go.
Oh.
And sleep. There we go. Okay, so watch this. Quick hypnosis. So this is what's going to happen. You're going to say in or out. Graphics out or graphics in. Go
okay.
for it. Yeah.
Out.
Out. Very good. Thank you. Are you left-handed or right-handed?
Right-handed.
Very good. What's your favorite color?
Green.
Very good. Mm-hmm. And these are all pointless. Okay. Out or in?
In.
In. Very good.
Yeah. I'm good at this.
You're very good at this. So are the kids. So here we go. So you're right-handed?
I am.
Take your right hand, go like that. Have you ever driven a motorcycle, ridden a motorcycle, ridden a bike, anything like that?
Yep, I have.
Very good. I want you to pretend like you're going to grab... Oh, wait, hold on. There you go. Okay, grab the steer, the handlebars.
Handlebars.
Very good. Now, we have the front...
I got carried away. I apologize.
Very good. Okay, cool. Okay, so we have the front two and the back two. Your choice.
The back two.
Very good. So we're going to take it. We're going to actually... You can relax that hand.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. I want you to step right here if you can. I'm going to come on this side. And on the count of three, because if this goes wrong, he can blame you. You're going to hold on to both of these. Uh-huh. So on the count of three, what we're going to do is we're actually going to pull the rope, and it's actually going to pull very tight across his hand.
Easy.
It's not a magic trick, guys.
He's telling
it's not a magic trick, okay? It's a prank. No, I'm joking. Here, okay, ready? One, two, three, pull. Ah! What?
Whoa!
Okay, he's real. I thought you were good. Still writing that. Yes.
I am, I'm writing.
Did you feel it?
I did, I felt it.
All right, they never do. That's awesome.
Cool. That was good.
Thank you.
What else you got?
Well, let's see. Usually what I'm used to. sir, I have one for you.
Okay, great.
Okay.
All right.
So I'm on YouTube, and I do magic and pranks on YouTube, and I've just been racking my brains. I was doing, like, the invisible chair. I just did a collaboration with Rich Ferguson. He's the guy that drops his head. And we just did, I was giving beer to bums. So that just went out to, hey, we cut out the middleman, right? And that's money. Right? Yeah. Thank you. So. I thought, you know what? Those are fun. Let's keep it simple. And you all know that magicians have a regular sized deck of cards. I wanted to do a social experiment.
I thought you were going to say something else.
You would. I wanted to do a social experiment to prove, does the size of the deck actually matter? I got you. I knew where you were going. I was just picking it up. Okay,
yeah,
so here we go. Can you do me a favor? Can you pick any card? Oh, first off, everyone knows they're normal. These are my grandparents' cards. They're like, if you're gonna do cards, bring the jumbo. I'm like, where's your prescriptions? Okay, so here we go. Pick any card. That one, very good. Show everyone, don't show me, that'd be cheating. You can show Jeff, show DJ T-Lin. Give me the Joker.
What?
What? Oh my goodness. I told you it was a normal deck. Okay, actually, you know what? Let's even do it a little bit. Do something even better. Why don't you take it? Can you cut the deck? Very good. Yeah, perfect. Do it again. Okay. Keep doing it until I say, until you want to stop. Okay. Got it? Keep going. Quicker. Okay. So now you have the choice of either the top or the bottom.
Okay.
Okay. Take that card. Hold on to it. And let me have the rest of
another great question.
Thank you. And this is even the best question of them all. He's holding a card. So what is it, right?
What is it? What is it, David Bonfadini?
The Jack of Clubs.
Is it?
No. So close.
I was off by one. That's okay. I guess it does matter, the size. So let's keep it going. Do me a favor, say stop.
Stop.
Very good. Go ahead and take the card.
Did I screw that joke up?
No, you know what? You just bit right into it. Okay, so do me a favor. Show everyone. Don't show me. And show DJ T-Lin. DJ T-Lin, will you come join me, young lady? Come out here. Give a round of applause. Very good. Now ready? Watch this. Very carefully. Uno, dos, tres. I just heard tres. Hi. You know what we call that? A mess. Okay, now I was told you need a tape. Do you have that?
Tape? Yeah. I don't have tape, no.
Oh, now we need your magic then. So go ahead and take this, take a piece. There you go, sign your name to it for me. Very, very good. Make sure you show everybody. Okay, very good, now watch this. Can you recap the marker? Yeah, recap. Yeah, we're in a recession. It's true. Okay, ready? Everyone, put your hands out here over my hands, and we're gonna do some magic. One, two, three. Cards are gone. You have a souvenir and it's signed. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm that good. Thank you very much!
Ladies and gentlemen, David Buffadini right here! I'm not sure what just happened.
So there is no magic.
I'm not sure what just happened.
In fact, this is a set dressing. This has everyone's signature on it. We'll do that again.
We did. It's so we dramatic. Signed a name earlier.
Here we go.
On that.
There you go. Ladies and gentlemen, there's one card.
There it is.
Put back together. DJ T.
There it is right there.
There's a match. Thank you very much.
Once again. David Bonfigini, take a seat, David. Okay. Take a seat. Take a seat. Oh, my goodness. My goodness. Yes, give him a high five for that one. We signed our names to that earlier. And you broke it. Can you put it back together? How's that trick work? Can you put it back together?
I'm a magician, Jeff, not a miracle man.
Yeah, obviously. Hey, let's talk about your magic life. You've been doing this for a while. When did you get started?
I got started when I was six.
Okay.
And it's funny because right around this time is when it happened. It's fair season. And there's a fair magician that actually goes around. And his name, well, back then it was the Great Zucchini. I think he got sued, so you can't do that. But nevertheless, he's still there. Mind you, I saw this guy when I was 6 years old. I'm 33.
He's still there.
I know, TV magic. Don't look at it. But yeah, he's still there. And he's a pitch man. So I do pitch magic, which is basically advertisement on my YouTube. I'm an influence marketing.
Uh-huh.
So it was kind of cool. He kind of sparked that from the beginning.
All right, good deal. Good deal. Now you have shows coming up here in San Diego?
Actually, right now everything is on YouTube.
Okay.
Right now I just did a series with Rich Ferguson. We did three videos and then.
Oh, that's great. I like him.
A couple of, yeah. He's a good guy.
I like him.
Good guy, yeah.
Well, I appreciate you coming on the show here tonight. I have one joke for you.
Oh, please.
I have one joke. Can you teach me a joke, actually? Or a trick as well? Because you're full of jokes. Teach me a trick.
Okay, I can teach you how to be funny.
You already know how to
break. Yeah, teach me how to be funny.
Let's see. This is really cool. First off, don't go swimming.
Okay.
Don't go swimming. Yeah, don't go swimming unless you use protective eyewear because that's when you can get pink eye.
Look at that. That is a pink eye.
So that's for you.
All right, I'll
make sure you wash your hands. See what I did there? That wasn't funny, it was punny.
Yeah, it was very punny.
Thank you.
I'm gonna put that on your deck of cards. Well, the only trick I've got for you is we actually forgot to give you anything in your cup. So unfortunately, that's all we've got. Ladies and gentlemen,
yes!
David Bonfadini right here. Thanks a lot, David. Hey, when we come back, we are gonna see live right here, him, Mitchy Brusco, when we come back. Hey, thanks a lot, bud. Appreciate it. Well, my next guest is only 18 years old and already has 5 medals in the X Games and also holds a world record for the first 1080 ever on a mega ramp. In fact, we got footage. Take a look. So fucked up. Mitchy Brusco.
Hello.
Good to have you on the show, Mitchy. Good to have you on the show.
Great to be here. I'm just happy to be here.
It is amazing, right? It's amazing. 18 years old, and well, Jesse said it. You're amazing. First, let's talk about the 1080. I know you've had a lot of interviews about the 1080.
Yes. Yes.
Being able to complete, you worked at it for a long time. You were standing up there. It is 90 feet high, dropping in, rolling down on a little stick with wheels on it, and then doing flips. Who does that? Why? I'll do it.
I mean, it sounds insane.
Pick me.
Like, ridiculous. Like, who does that? Like, you don't wake up and try that. But the process to practicing it, it's a long road. I've been skating for a long time. And the way you practice those kind of things, you take it really slow. There's so many steps, so many safe ways around the trick where there's 100 things to learn before you can do it. So really, the trick is to be able to try it without getting hurt.
Yeah.
And then you can give it 100 shots, and then one of them, you
football
know,
pads. Did you, first it. Time wearing football pads, a helmet, shoulder
I've
pads?
I've gone through my pad phases,
yeah?
The shin guards, the gloves, the shoulder pads. For that kind of stuff, I've had to get up, and now I've toned it down. I like to be comfortable. I figured if it goes so bad I need shoulder pads, the shoulder pads aren't going to help too much.
I need a prayer just to go down, just to go down a slide at the park. Yeah. That's what I need. That's what I need. Well, you're 18. You started very, very young.
Mm-hmm.
Started
3 years
very,
old.
Very young. Three years old. I mean, you were on, was it Good Morning America? Was that what it was?
The Today Show.
The Today Show.
Yeah, I was like 5 years old. I could barely do an interview. All I wanted to talk about was great popsicles and my older brother. So, I mean, they had it. They showed video of me skating around. And I was kind of the first, you know, one of the first younger, like really young kids to have a knack for skating and kind of do it early. Now there's 6 years old, 5 years old, kids doing vert ramps and this and that. So it's kind of cool to be.
You've done that. You've done Jimmy Kimmel.
Done Jimmy Kimmel. That was a fun interview.
That's got to be really fun.
Yeah, he's... All those guys, they're so fun to talk to.
It's Conan, a year ago, and finally you're making it to the big dogs. The
now I get
show
to the real. Yeah. Finally a real interview.
And finally a real interview.
Finally,
yeah, exactly.
Made it. Yep.
Yeah, exactly. Well, I was watching. I was watching the Conan episode. Conan, he is my arch nemesis. He was here in San Diego during Comic-Con, did a show, did not invite me to one single show. So Conan, you're not allowed to come to my show either. How do you like them apples, Conan, huh?
He's probably threatened by the hair.
He's threatened by the hair. Is that what it is? He's got a nice little coif too, doesn't he? He got a little thing. Well, I saw the interview, and he brought out to you, he said, Michi, I know that you like peanut butter shakes, and so here you go.
That's an amazing impression.
You like that? Yeah. Here you go.
Is there Conan behind there?
Yeah, you think it is. But, you know, with Conan doing that, I thought, Conan, amateur. We can definitely do a lot better than that. Do we have something for Michi out here? We have something. Your favorite thing, peanut butter shakes.
I do like them.
We got something better for you out here. Look at that.
What? Yeah,
that's right.
Wow.
One for you.
Blew the competition out of the water.
And one for me. That's right. Go ahead and take a bite. It's okay. Take a bite. Here, let's go ahead and cheers it. Let's go ahead and cheers it. Ready? Yeah. Eat your heart out, Conan. How do you like that, huh? So you give me here. Well, I saw recently that you're doing the Special Olympics. You're an ambassador for the Special Olympics when it comes to action sports. Action sports aren't involved in the Special Olympics
yet. Yeah, not quite yet.
But you're kind of like the conduit in between.
Bridging the gap.
Yeah, absolutely. And it's really, really cool to see you out there.
Thank
you. The pictures
thank
I see
you.
Online are amazing. And the kids love you.
Yeah,
they love
you.
You are the idol of idols. How'd you get involved with that?
Well, first I got the opportunity. My manager approached me and said, hey, we're going to do some skateboarding with Special Olympian athletes. And we're going to just work with them, see how it goes, and maybe we'll get involved with Special Olympics. Depends how. And then first day, I just fell in love. It became a passion project for me. I took every opportunity I could. Thank you, guys. And their whole thing is unity. Is, you know, unify the people through sports. And I feel like skateboarding is a great vehicle to get kids that otherwise honestly wouldn't leave their room, don't have the friends, aren't socially capable. And they can, you know, if someone can ride down the street on their skateboard, that could make their lives. So
absolutely.
If I can give someone that opportunity and in the process play some soccer and play some softball at the World Games with them, and it's just, I've been having a lot of fun. We're definitely making steps forward. It's such a big project that it moves slow, but it'll be going full speed ahead soon.
We need you to hang out here at the Tonight San Diego show too, because there's a lot of us that are special, and so we would actually need your help as well. It would be great to help us move forward as well. Although we're better than Conan. We're better than, look at Conan, you see that? Yeah. Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. Well, we talked about
the
X Games.
Straw. There's a straw.
I know there's a straw. Can you get anything out of it? It'll melt.
Nothing
it'll melt.
For later.
So we talked about the X Games. Five medals. You've got three bronze, two silver.
Three bronze, two silvers. Trying to make that step
that's
into the
next
gold.
Step.
Yeah, I've been really, you know, kind of slaving away at the ramp. really putting time in the gym, really trying to make that. That's a huge next step from just getting on the podium in general is big. And then to get from top three to the top spot is a whole different world. So
what's a gym workout like for skateboarding? You just ollie in place?
We try to get creative. It's called
Gleam the Cube or whatever? I don't know.
A lot of similar stuff to golf and baseball where it's sports specific, core rotation, balance stuff. So working a lot with
Jesse,
like,
you don't understand.
I know everything.
Jesse, you don't understand, okay? Leave it to the professionals over here.
He's talking about Pilates or something.
Yeah, working about basically drawing rotational power from an uneven surface.
With P90s and stuff, I got you. Yeah. I'm with that.
That guy over there.
Science.
Right? Mm-hmm. Abs.
Science.
So many abs.
Science. Speaking of practice, getting ready,
NBC Dude Tour is
coming into Los Angeles in 2 weeks, and you got the invite.
Yeah, just got the invite. It was up in the air for a minute. I didn't know if I was going to get invited, and then
of course they're going to have you. Come on, Mitchie Brusco. Come on, of course they're going to have you.
I've been working with the Dude Tour for 10 years now, doing demos, one-off things whenever I could, just get my name in there, try to meet people and skate the ramp.
Well, your name's been there for a long time. You and I, we've known each other. I've known this kid since he was 8 years old. 10 years
time.
I've known this kid here. From Washington, Seattle area originally. You came down here a few years ago, but I've known you for a long time, and the growth that you've had in the sport, you've transitioned the sport from where it was to where it is now.
Yeah.
It's humongous. So seeing you in LA in a couple of weeks, that's going to be happening,
The 14th. It starts at 4 p.m.
4 p.m.?
It's a Friday.
The Ace Hotel?
The Ace Hotel in downtown Los Angeles.
Oh, it's gonna be great. So you got to tune in NBC Sports, and you guys can watch it at 4 p.m. at the Ace Hotel. Real quick, want to talk to you about your extracurricular activities because I saw recently you jumped out of a plane.
Yeah.
Yeah, you do it a lot. It's like 20 times you've done it now.
Well, I turned 18 and I naturally just started jumping out of planes.
Naturally.
Oh yeah.
I have 30.
As I go back to my ice cream cone, naturally. Yeah.
So I had 30 solo jumps now.
So
just
turn 18.
Fallen in love with the sport.
It's already bucket list time.
It's already bucket list. Yeah.
It's like 18, old hat. I got to jump.
Morgan Freeman and Jack Nicholson sitting right there. What do you want to do next, huh, Mitchie? What do you want to do next? Anything you want to do.
Well, it's really a natural process. I did the tandem jump, tied to the instructor, just basically taking me along for the ride. Signed up the next day to get solo certified, and
in your blood,
since
though.
Then, 30 jumps later, and I've just fallen in love with it. I feel like I've unlocked a whole new world now. I look up and see a playground.
Is that right?
Yeah,
I look up and look for birds.
Where?
You see a playground, I see an umbrella, hopefully, in my future. I don't know. So, but I mean, you're doing a lot there. You're doing a lot when it comes to jumping out of a plane. Yeah. You're doing stuff in the snow.
Golfing, surfing, snowboarding, whatever I can get my hands on.
Does your agent freak out?
No. He knows that I stay safe, but it's skateboarding.
Stay safe. I'm gonna jump out of a plane.
Yeah.
But don't worry. I've taken all the precautions.
Chill.
I brought a skateboard with me.
Skateboarding is so hard on your body that I can't skate for more than 2-3 hours in a day, or else I can't do it the next day. I can't walk because my legs hurt or did this. I got tired and fell. So I can mix it up and get on the golf course, waste 4 hours, keep my mind busy, so when I come back to skateboarding, it's fresh and new, and I'm excited for it, and the passion's still there. So it's a big reason I do all the other stuff, but in the meantime, I've just fallen in love with like 7 different sports.
Yeah, well, the whole world's fallen in love with you at the Special Olympics. Dude Tour's coming out, the extracurricular activities there. Ladies and gentlemen, Mitchie Brusco here at Tonight in San Diego. When we come back, DJ Noel 2033, he'll be here as well. Hey, Mitchie, thanks a lot, man.
Thank you.
Another ice cream bite. So every week, if you are in the studio audience, you can get great prizes just like this. We've got 4 free admission passes and a $50 gift card to the Shout House here on 4th Avenue downtown San Diego. Just get in tonight at sandiego.com, get your tickets, and get here to the show. My next guest here tonight is a fantastic artist, very well known throughout San Diego, fantastic DJ, DJ Noel 2033.
Thank you.
Oh, it's good to have you. It's good to have you on the show, man. You're looking good.
Thank you, Graham.
Looking good, looking good. You and I, we work together when it comes to fashion. Fashion, you're looking very fashionable. You're always looking fashionable.
Not as good as you.
Oh, you know, hey, took 3 days to get ready for this. That's why we do it one day a week. That's why it takes a lot of preparation. So, DJ.
Yes.
Great transition, right? Great transition. Oh, you're good. DJ.
Yes.
So I want to know where you play throughout San Diego, because I see stuff all over your social media, resident management as well. There's a lot that's going on with you. So tell us a little bit of background about you.
Well, I started DJing when I was 15 years old, and I just found that as to be my passion and just stuck with it to now. And I kind of spun that off to a management company where we're managing DJs, musicians, and artists. Like a Quill, we had a Quill here.
Recently. Yeah. He was on NBC's The Voice, season 3, I think. Mm-hmm. Yeah. He's a great artist, fantastic.
So, you know, kind of more of an entrepreneurial spirit. So I just wanted to make sure that I had something when I did decide to stop DJing, to have something to fall back on and kind of help my peers that I'm working with. So
businessman.
Yeah,
business
a little bit. Just a little bit.
Yeah. I like that. So where do you play out regularly here in San Diego?
I've been DJing.
Do you spin still? Is that what you call it? It's a spin?
It's what Thielen's doing.
Yeah.
Thielen works with us.
Are you
part of the crew?
Right? You spin? Is that the cool thing to say?
That's right.
Spin.
Yeah.
That's right. Look at me spin. Go. Spin.
Say it again.
You don't even say it that good.
I don't say it that good. Spin. Come watch me spin.
Yeah. I thought you get turnt. Don't you get turnt?
Turnt?
Aren't you getting turnt?
You're missing a word. It's called turnt up.
Turnt up. Yeah, get it right, Jesse.
I got to turnt it down.
Get it right. Well,
turn it down.
Noelle's going to teach us all the cool things.
No, but I DJ all over, and I don't really have specific places that I'm at every week, because I get a lot of opportunities to be able to do some great things. Like this past weekend, I was at Hard Rock for the first luxury MMA fight here in San Diego. So I get a lot of phone calls to come and do like
special guest appearances.
Yeah.
Have you come out there?
I've been very blessed to be able to be the first one to do a lot of stuff.
Well, speaking of tonight, it's pretty exciting. Explain to us what we're going to see tonight, because I've actually never seen this before. You're going to be spinning and going to be turned up.
Turned up.
So you're going to be doing that.
Yeah.
And you've got saxophone playing as well. And you've got, explain what we're going to see tonight.
So from DJing so long, you kind of, I won't say you don't get bored, but you want to take it to higher levels. And I went to Vegas one time to Club Pure, and I saw DJ AM and Travis Barker. And Travis Barker was playing the drums, and DJ AM was DJing, and I just was like, whoa. So I actually have a brother that plays the drums, and so we started doing the DJ drummer thing here in San Diego, and then I thought about adding a saxophone and a trumpeter and a violinist and a percussionist. And so today what everybody's gonna see is I'll be out here with one of our residents, Jeremy. He's a saxophonist, and my good friend Chuck Prada, who used to play with the Black Eyed Peas and Carlos Santana.
Oh, nice.
He'll be on the percussions together.
Oh, nice, that's gonna be great. I'm excited about that. Yeah. Well, you were talking about some of our residents. How does somebody become a resident? What's the process? Somebody says, I want to be a part of resident management. I want to work with DJ Noel and the rest of his residents. How does that happen?
Yeah, honestly, it just happens, because we don't really solicit.
Okay.
You know, we kind of.
I'm just trying to figure out where to send my demo reel.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I think.
Just trying to get turnt.
Yeah. You should probably just send that to maybe the North Pole. That
North Pole? Got it. Santa, we're coming for ya! Me and Jesse are good additions to
those elves are getting turnt.
Turnt up.
Turnt them elves.
Turnt. I apologize on behalf of Jesse over there.
I thought you were apologizing for yourself.
I should be. Absolutely should be. It's embarrassing. We're not cool at all. Well, sitting next to you, it's nerve-wracking.
No, it should. You guys do a great job. This is so awesome for San Diego.
Hey, you know, this is. We appreciate that. And this is honestly the only reason why we do this, and we're so you know, blessed and great at what we do, the response we've got, is because of talent like you, talent that we've had over the last, well, 50 episodes. So we appreciate you guys out there, because you guys are what makes San Diego spectacular and America's finest city. We appreciate that.
There's a lot of talent out here.
It is.
San Diego is a hidden gem. There's a lot of talent.
That's right. That's right.
Singers, artists, there's a lot. Everybody, there's a lot of stuff.
Oh, there's a ton. Where can people find you?
They can go to DJNoel2033.com. All my social media is at DJNoel2033. And if they want to check out the management company, it's residentmgmt.com.
Okay, got me to see your hat. I'm gonna get turned up right here. Ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, there it is.
Ladies and gentlemen, DJ Noel 2033.
You're not wearing it
to
right.
See that. We're not wearing it right. How do I wear it?
We're like this.
DJ Brown.
Come back on the resident management stage. DJ Noel 2033 and his posse. Mm-hmm. We'll be back. The resident management stage, Chuck on percussion, Jeremy on saxophone, and ladies and gentlemen, here is DJ Noel 2033. big show tonight. A lot of fun. Hey, but it wouldn't be possible without our sponsors. I want to thank Second Street Printing. I want to thank also Stiesle Photography, all the great pictures they take throughout the entire show each and every week. Also, the patio restaurants. They've got two of them, one on Lamont in Pacific Beach. Also, the patio on Goldfinch. The Lafayette Hotel. In fact, tonight we gave away two swim club pool party passes to the live studio audience. And you guys can win it as well. You just have to be here tonight in SanDiego.com. And of course, the Horton Grand Theater for once again allowing us to make this our playground like we do each and every week. I want to thank my guests here tonight, magician David Bonfadini, skateboarder Mitchie Brusco, once again here, ladies and gentlemen, on the Resident Management stage, DJ Noel 2033. See you next week.